New book out called Leonard, My 50-Year Friendship with a Remarkable Man. And it's written by one William Shatner, who joins us on the phone right now. Good morning, William Shatner.
Good morning. And there, yes, one. There is only one.
This is kind of a bucket list thing.
I just got chills.
To Kirk!
If there were two, I'd send one to you.
I would caress that second one. Good morning, Mr. Shatner, American icon, yes, author. Tell us about the book, Leonard. You have a... There's peanut butter, there's jelly, there's salt, there's pepper, there's light, there's dark, and there is Kirk and Spock.
That's great.
You hear that, Mike? It's great.
Well, that's true, and there was Leonard and Bill. We were thrust into each other's company as a result of Star Trek. We started a friendship there, usually in show business, and maybe it's happened to you guys on radio. You make it a really good friend working together, and you talk between in commercials, and then somebody leaves, either goes to another job or passes away, and those memories of the experiences you've had and the talks you had that were just between the two of you, all that leaves because you have no more validation on remember when, and that's the reason for the book.
Talk to me about Leonard Nimoy's sense of humor, because so many generations knew him as, and will forever know him as, the stoic, emotionless to a degree, Mr. Spock. But that wasn't the man, Leonard Nimoy. He actually had an incredible sense of humor. Talk to me about that side of him that we didn't get to see.
Well, we would be on stage at personal appearances frequently. I mean, maybe over the years that we did, hundreds of times. So that in order to amuse the audience, we amused ourselves.
Right.
And hoping the audience would laugh along, which they did. And his sense of timing, his humor, his perception, we were foils for each other. And he was wonderful on stage. And I got to know him as well on stage by questioning him, as the audience did, and as I did when we were not on stage and having dinner together.
I know you must get asked this question a lot, but can you believe, you know, Star Trek was so long ago, but it still seems so very much alive. So very much alive today.
It's the strangest. It's the most phenomenal thing in show business that this thing is still alive. 50 years. This is the 50th anniversary of when it went on, when the Star Trek I was in went on the air. And that's remarkable that there's another movie coming out, and I've written a book which is called Leonard, and we're talking about it.
Yeah, does it, William Shatner, does it amaze you, and I don't mean this to be rude, but I mean...
But if you're going to be rude...
but that you've remained to stay so relevant? I mean, not even just relevant, you're
iconic.
You're iconic at this point.
Is iconic relevant?
Both. I mean, you're relevant, you're iconic, you're everybody
sought
loves
after.
You, you're sought
for
after.
For the right reasons, too. Not infamous in the way that a reality star is somebody. You have a body of work, you have a catalog that is respected, and it will be studied and appreciated long after your eventual, hopefully down the road, passing, much in the same way your friend Leonard's will be.
Thank you for saying down the road.
Down the road. Many decades from now.
I mean, you do have to be amazed looking back.
Or indeed what the speed limit is on down the road. Yes, well, I thank you for that. I don't know how that feels. It sounds ponderous, and I'm blundering around trying to find my shoes, but thank you for saying that.
The book is called Leonard, My 50-Year Friendship with a Remarkable Man. And it's no secret, you know, if you've read some pre-reviews of this and some recent interviews with you, that you said, and I quote, "I don't know why he, Leonard Nimoy, stopped talking to me," in your new memoir about Mr. Spock. Leonard, do you have any ideas as to where the rift between you two might have emanated from?
I have no idea. And that mystery is profound for me, and there's no way of solving it. So it is unanswered. And it's lovely to think that everything ties up neatly in life, but life isn't like that. It has tattered endings and tattered beginnings, and the sides are not marginal. Life is just life, and
wow,
that will be a mystery.
So he passed, obviously, February 27, 2015, age 83. And at that point of his passing, your relationship with him was what?
I sent him a note in his last days,
yeah,
saying how much I cared for him, and I never got a response on it.
That's tough.
The book is Leonard, My 50-Year Friendship with a Remarkable Man. And moving on to a lighter topic, new Star Trek films coming out for a new generation, but with a new cast. How do you feel Chris Pine has done taking on the iconic mantle of Captain James T. Kirk of the Starship Enterprise, made famous by you?
Well, he's such a good-looking, athletic guy. He's a wonderful actor, and he's young. So he's enviable, isn't he?
I'll be honest.
Yeah.
I don't
think
he kicks quite as much ass as you did. You were one of the few captains. God love Picard. Okay, but he would talk it out. Captain Kirk, he'd drop the tricorder and throw hands at a lizard man if needed.
That's true. I'm going to agree with you on that.
Thank you. There he is, William Shatner.
Come on.
Leonard, My 50-Year Relationship.
Yeah.
With a Remarkable Man. We really appreciate you taking the time of speaking with us this morning, sir.
Pleasure is mine. Take care of yourself.
Take care. My God, wow. The timbre in that man's voice.
There
William Shatner.
Yeah.